Oh, yes, and we got him.
Oh, I've got one. I'm in. Hey, that's really excellent. Oh, he's a big one. Fantastic fish. Absolutely beautiful. We must put her back.
Wonderful new dimension to fly fishing. We're fishing a very kind of fish, but some of the really gives you a battle on this tackle. That's what I love.
And off he goes.
This is the Giant's Causeway, one of Ireland's most famous tourist attractions, situated on the spectacular north coast. According to legend, it was built by the Irish giant Finn McCool during a feud with a Scottish rival. But science accounts for these unusual rock formations as simply the product of volcanic action millions of years ago. Each year, thousands of tourists are drawn here by the myth and the mysteries of nature. They come to look and to clamber around on the rocks, or just to sit and marvel at nature's diversity. And some come here for purely selfish reasons.
This is the wishing chair at the Giant's Causeway, right up on the north coast of Antrim. Today I'm going shore fishing for pollack, but conditions aren't quite ideal, so I've come here to see if I can get a little help. A big pollack, please. I want a really big pollack today, the biggest one in the sea. A big pollack, please, please. A big pollack, I want the biggest fish.
£10 fish caught from the shore are not uncommon, and any fish over £3 will give a good account of itself on light tackle. They like rocky or man-made structures, but they can be found most often lying on beds of kelp near the bottom. Thus, the best marks to fish are those with fairly deep water close to the shore.
Well, this is it. This is my chosen spot. Just a quick talk through the tackle. You really can use any freshwater tackle as long as you give it a good rinse out afterwards, but standard 10-foot spinning rod, ordinary multiplier or fixed spool reel. I use 12-pound line. Some people might say that's a bit too light with all these rocks and kelp around, but no problem at all. Pollack will always give you a better fight on light tackle. Down at the terminal end, that's what I'm using. This is a flying sea. It's caught a few salmon, wee bit dog-eared. Not quite up to it for the king of fish, but do okay for pollack. You can just see there that the hooks are getting a wee bit past it. It's already been used once or twice, and you can see that it's going downhill big time. Perfect for the pollack. Another essential piece of kit is this. Some people can do without this, but when you're using 12-pound line, you can't always hike the fish up, especially if the sea's down a little bit. An extending landing net gives you loads and loads and loads of reach. Absolutely essential. And one thing you've got to always, always be aware of when you're sea fishing, you cannot spend too much time watching those waves.
Several local anglers had told me that the fishing was poor, with very few big pollack being caught in recent days. Fishing is all about adapting to the situation, and as far as I'm concerned, catching smaller fish is a lot better than catching no fish at all.
I'm going to change my rig. The flying sea is a wee bit light, it's quite deep here. And there's a fairly strong tide running there, so I'm going to put on something that's got a bit of weight. That's a great lure for big pollack. Super lure, swims upside down, hook avoids all the snags, and this tail gives a beautiful action in the water. I've caught a lot of big pollack in that, but there's not very big pollack in this area. So what I'm going to do is tie on a dropper further up my line, and I'm going to put a fly on, and very often that can kill a lot of fish. These are the streamers I normally use for pollack. They're tarpon flies, anything else. This is one of my favourite ones. Very, very simple fly, and it's just bucktail. And when you're tying bucktail on the fly, it's always dark on the top, lightest on the bottom. And that has killed quite a lot of pollack, but I'm not going to use those. I'm going to use a much smaller fly, probably something quite bright like that. Silver, white or yellow. That's got a treble hook on it, so any pollack takes its mine. And I'm going to put that about 2 feet or 3 feet up the line on a dropper from my lure.
Effectively, I was using the big lure to get the fly down among the fish. And of course, there's always the chance of the lure itself producing a big one. But with poor conditions, I was pinning all my hopes on the fly.
Well, there you are, folks. It's not exactly worth coming out for, but I suppose it's better than catching nothing. Small fly always produces small fish. That's about second or third cast, and we're straight into a fish. Not quite as good as I expected, but if the big fish come in here now and the tide's rising, we should have a few better ones than this. We're in. Well, at least it's a pollack. Another one. Oh, and another one.
Well, despite my wish, I didn't catch a good sized pollack. The fishing wasn't great, but at least I managed a few small fish by adapting my tactics. Hopefully, I'll have better luck tomorrow. Finding a spot that holds good fish is the key to success, and anglers that do best know all the local hotspots and move around them regularly. A few anglers I'd spoken to recommended a mark called the Pan Rocks, and even though it's a few miles along the coast, I'm off to give it a try.
Well, I've moved on to this beautiful little place called the Pan, or the Pan Rocks. It's a nice little causeway coming out into the sea, and I've got shelter on this side, deep water close in, and I've changed to the fly rod. A pollack of about 2 or 3 pounds will give you a great fight on a fly rod. The problem is that fishing with a fly in the sea off the rocks is a lot more limiting than using spinning tackle. You've got to have deep water close in where you can get your fly out, let it get right down to the kelp bed, and then retrieve. Normally that's where the pollack are lying. In order to get a bit of range, it's almost essential to use this. It's a shooting head. Now, if you're using a standard 30 yard full length fly line, a good caster can cast at 30 yards, but with one of these, it's 10 yards of fly line, and you've got this light running backing. It's called a shooting head. It's pretty standard kit. You can put it out 35 yards every time. If you hook a pollack, it all happens in the first 5 or 6 seconds. The pollack goes hell for leather for the kelp. If he gets in there, and with a fly rod, very often he does, if he's sizable, the best way to get him out is to feed him slack line. Give him about 5 seconds, 10 seconds, often he'll swim out, and then you can pull your line clear and you're into the battle again. It takes a wee bit of getting used to the saltwater fishing, but if you crack it, you'll be hooked. Excellent. One of the nice things about pollack fishing is if the fish are there, they'll take. Now there's a shoal of pretty small pollack in here, but it seems to be a fairly sizable shoal. And every time you put your fly down into it, you'll get one. Oh, yes. Excellent. It's not a monster, but it's another one.
The Pan Rocks is a beautiful spot and a popular mark with the locals. When the sun came out, I decided to stay and enjoy the rest of my day catching the small but plentiful pollack. Millions of people head for the beach every summer to enjoy the sea. But when I visit the seaside, I much prefer a fishing rod and lots of rocks.
Oh, and it's another. Oh, even a small pollack like that can really give you a good pull. Oh, and in fact, it's a coalfish. Now, there we have a slightly different species. This little guy is very similar to the pollack, except the easiest way to identify this fish is that he's got a white lateral line instead of a black one. Very similar to the pollack. Sit still. And the interesting thing there was that I caught him a lot closer to the surface. That adds a wee bit of interest to our day. It's not every day you can expect a 4 or a 5 pounder, or even a 7 pounder, but you still have super sport with these small pollack and coalfish.
Thank you.